Okay, so where are we? Well, we're at my place at the minute. It's the day before I'm going fishing, and basically I've had a few bad sessions since I've been, and I ain't had much time to go. So I'm trying now to maximise. I've got a 2-day sesh coming up now, and now I don't know if I'm going to do this video as part of the sesh or I might just put it on separately, but what I'm doing at the minute is prepping my bait, and I'll be doing some rigs later as well, and I might video that. We'll see how it goes. But basically, well, you see I've got some gloves on here, right, because the bait I'm doing, it stinks, it reeks, you know what I mean, and it's summertime now, and I'm going to go for like a fishy bait rather than fruity bait. Don't get me wrong, the plum, you know what I mean, it works, you know it works, you've seen it work, but I'm going to go for a bit more of a fish meal based bait this time. When I go, just to try something out a little bit different that I know I used to use a lot in the past, and I'm just going to go back to it and see where it is. I'll let you know what the bait is. Where's it gone? What I'm using, what I'm going to use anyway. Oh, basically this stuff, it's called probiotic. Comes in two different styles. You've got the red one and the brown one. Now I prefer the red, purely because the day I first saw it and heard about it, the bloke was using the red one, and he was just hauling them in. Couldn't believe it. Just started using it. Cut a long story short, I just had massive results on it. Then I got hold of the plum, and this stopped working. A couple of sessions. You know what I mean, well, it not stopped working, but I was slowing down. And I thought, well, I'd have a switch, different bait, what have you. And the plum started working. Now the plum's starting to slow down a bit. I think it's just because it's summer, I think, you know what I mean? So I'm going to go back to this one. It's made by Starbaits. A lot of the stuff that I use is Starbait stuff. And you'll be able to find it on, just type in justcarping.co.uk, and it'll take you to the Starbaits website. You can buy it. Absolutely fantastic bait. And I'll tell you what it smells like. It's like a tomato-y pasta sauce. So it's fish meal. These are the shelf life versions, obviously, as you can see. But absolutely brilliant bait. Right, so what am I going to do? I'm going to prep some ground bait stuff. I'm going to make my stick mixes and stuff like that, but I'm not going to do fizz bombs, purely because the stuff that I'm going to use now is going to have a massive oil content. Massive oil content, right? And I've started prepping it already, okay, and I'll just show you what I'm using. Basically, I've got Swim Stim Dynamite Betaine Green ground bait. And that's going in with a 50-50 mix with, yet again, Dynamite Marine Halibut ground bait. Okay, that's 50-50 mix in there. Used to use it a lot when I first started out fishing, the Marine Halibut one. Used to come in a can and used to have to, and it was pre-mixed, stuff like that, very oily. Basically, just it's all like crushed down Marine Halibut pellets, I suppose. And then the Swim Stim, it's a bit of green, so it changes the colour of it. Now, I was watching a DVD the other week, and it had Nick Hellier on it. And he's a massive... He started the Dynamite sticks, a little PVA sticks in the mesh that you compress down. And he sort of mastered it, and he still is the master of it. And he, you know what I mean, he catches fish on it all the time. So I was watching him, and I thought, oh, okay, well, I'll take that on board, and I'll give that a shot. So what I've done, if you can see here, a 50-50 mix of Marine Halibut and the Swim Stim Green, right? But what I've done is, like I said before, it's got massive oil content, right? I've added an old bottle of Marine Halibut oil. That's not a whole bottle, obviously, just like a couple of squirts and whatever. And then I've got a tin here of tuna chunks in sunflower oil, and I've just basically emptied the oil into that as well. Now the way it looks at the minute, lumpy, really lumpy. Alright, so what I'm going to do now is show you a trick of the trades, which old Stokesy showed me, and I've seen it before as well, but Stokesy showed me. For those of you who don't know, Stokesy used to be a massive match angler, and then I persuaded him to turn into carp angler. Alright, so I've got a plastic bag here. I'm just going to empty that bad boy in now. Make sure I get all that out. Okay. So step one, right. Now as you can see, still really lumpy in there. Mash it up a little bit, I suppose. But, still going to be lots of lumps in there. So, what do we do to combat that? Right. Let's see if we can see that there. An old sieve. Basically, all I'm going to do is just put it over the ground bait or the bowl like that, the bait bowl. And maybe if I put that there. Right, so the sieve's there. I'm just going to pour it in a little bit at a time. And all the little bits there are going through. And what I'm going to be left with only that little tiny bit there, and where all these lumps are is just basically lumps of like oil that have taken up the ground bait and made it into this kind of like paste. That's what you do, just break them up. Still loads of lumps in there, just working them out. Makes a bit of a mess this, so don't be doing it in your kitchen or your missus' place. Like I say, I'm in my little den, my little fishing den as such. Just working this through. Trying to get all through. Right. And as we get into it, all the small lovely bits have gone through, oily and that. And all we're left with here is basically, I don't know if you can see, little bits of the pellet that won't go through, okay? Now they're all broken up, and we've got no lumps, we've just got this bit of pellet in, so they can go back in. Alright. What I'm going to do is just keep doing that until I've got the whole stuff done. Alright? Right, so coming up to the final stages now, taking a bit of time, but as you can see, still got like the lumps in it, alright? Now, that's the things I don't want. Okay, so yet again, working them through. I'm happy with the little tiny bits of biscuit, pellet and that, because it basically, it's like a bit of crumb, like salmon crumb or something, but obviously it's not salmon crumb, it's a little bit of crumb. So that can go in. And the reason I'm doing this is so that, remember I told you I put all that oil in, that can get to every little molecule, rather than wasting some on them big old lumps, which I don't want. Still going. Takes forever, doesn't it? Bloody ages. Here we go, getting to the final stages now. A few little lumps. Here we go. And what we're left with, the lovely light and fluffy mix, which all the oils and stuff can get to. Going to be now, they're so soft and powdery rather than before when they had all them lumps. So that now all sieved, ready to go. What I'm going to do, I'm going to leave that now until tomorrow, and hopefully all that oil would have sorted itself out. And we can go from there. Right, next bit. What I've done, I'm going to be spotting tomorrow. Once I've found the areas. So what I've done is I've prepped some particle. Alright. And the way I've done that is I've boiled it, this mixed particle, basically pigeon conditioner, and some hemp, and I've boiled it up for a little while, and now what I've done is I've transferred it into a thermal container, and then put some more boiling water in there, and I'm going to leave that overnight to let it basically still soak in and what have you. And the reason you do this, number one, soften up all the particles and that, so they don't swell up in the animal's belly, in the carp's belly or any little fish, what have you. And number two is because you don't want any particles that could grow. The fisheries don't want, you spilling your particle and then a bloody tree sprouting up or what have you. So that's why we do that, just in case you're wondering that. So I'll show you the particle mix and I'll tell you what I've done to it.
If you watch, as I open it up, see a steam coming out. Alright, so in there. Little seeds and stuff like that, okay. A few boilies, and that there, basically cooking away. You can see how like black the hemp is and stuff like that, and all the seeds, they're all cracking open and what have you. I might even put a little bit more water in that. Let's see. Now, what I've done in there is I've added some chilli powder and a load of salt as well. Salt, fish just like salt, carp love it. It's a flavour enhancer, isn't it? Do you know what I mean? So if that's going to bring out some nice flavour of them boilies or the particle and what have you, okay? Now, remember earlier what I said about I've added the tuna oil to me thingy. What do you do with the tuna? Well, I'm going to put it in here. So. So I've got the tin of tuna. And you know what? I've just moved my knife out of the time. Okay, so trusty Swiss Army knife. Watch your fingers when you're doing this. Okay, so that is just going straight in now. Just there it is. Alright, it's only cheap stuff. Well, it's not cheap stuff, is it? What is it? Prince's. It's not too cheap, but you can do it with any tuna, I suppose. And I've actually got a tin of salmon down there, but I'm in an R in whether to use it or not. I might just leave that out. So, that's the tin of tuna. Now, you see in here, it's just in there in lumps at the minute, right? So you need to break that up into all little pieces before you start mixing it around, because otherwise, just like the ground bait, you'll end up with big chunks that ain't really doing much. Whereas if you get the little, tiny little fibres and what have you, you know how tuna breaks up. Get the little fibres in and out of every little bit of particle that you're going to spot out. Then it'll be better for you. Be a little bit of tuna kicking out. Wherever you go. Now, some people say, some people do, put tuna in their little stick mixes and stuff like that. I used to, but I never really found it make much of a difference, because when I used to do like proper little dynamite sticks, I never used to add tuna, and I used to do fine for catching fish. Just used to add my ground bait and what have you, crushed pellet. But now I add a bit to my spod mix. That's lovely, that now. Fibrous. Now, I told you I added boiling water to this, right? So, it's pretty hot at the minute. So what I'm going to do is stir it around with my stirrer. Wherever that's gone. There it is behind you. Right, so, let's get all of them. Right there to the bottom. Looking good. And then, final ingredient, okay? With your boilies on, whatever boilies you're using, if you're planning on just using one boilie, which I am, put a little bit of dip in there, a little bit of glug. Flavour it up. Like I say, tomato pasta sauce. Lovely. Always do the lid up. The amount of times I've left the lid off, even when I'm on the bank, and knocked it over. And they're quite pricey, the old dips and glugs, as you probably know. Some of them could be up to like 10 quid a bottle. So I'll be messing about with that. Love it. And as this seed is steaming away and sorting itself out, draws in a load of moisture from the water, and it'll also draw in that liquid. And there you are, that'll be left till tomorrow, when that'll be lovely and smelling of the old probiotic. So, still got my gloves on. Still got my gloves on, so get rid of them. And then what I'm going to do is tie some rigs. I'll show you that in a minute.